हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल टीच यू द लेसन हाइड्रोस्फीयर एंड व्हाट इज स्पॉटलाइट। व्हाट वी विल स्टडी इन दिस लेसन अबाउट हाइड्रोस्फीयर एंड द वाटर साइकिल, सैलिनिटी एंड इट्स वेरिएशन इन डिफरेंट ओशन वाटर्स, मूवमेंट इन ओशन वाटर, effects of ocean water movements. Okay, first of all about hydrosphere, realm of water. Hydrosphere, hydro means water. Water is a vital component of life. Without water, life is impossible. Nobody can live without water. Okay, and over 2/3 of our planet is occupied by numerous water bodies, whether they are oceans or they are seas. And we also know that our planet Earth is also known as blue planet, owing to the importance of water and large presence of water on its surface. Right, about 71% of the Earth's surface is covered by water. All the water bodies like oceans, seas, lakes, rivers, etc. are altogether known as hydrosphere. What is hydrosphere? All the water bodies like oceans, seas, lakes, rivers, etc. are altogether known as hydrosphere. The water in these bodies is perennially in a natural cycle of evaporation, condensation and precipitation known as water cycle. Right. Let us study this water cycle in detail. What is the water cycle? Okay, the water cycle has no starting or ending point as such. Nevertheless, for the sake of understanding, we shall start from the oceans, as that is where most of the Earth's water exists. The water in the oceans and seas is heated by the sun. Okay, is heated by the sun. As the water heats up, it evaporates, i.e. it turns into water vapor. Water is also evaporated from the soil also. The trees and the forest also contribute moisture to the air through transpiration. This water vapor rises into the air, and due to lower air temperature at heights, condensation occurs, converting mass of water vapor into clouds. Further cooling makes these clouds heavier with water. This develops into rain bearing clouds. The air currents move clouds, and cloud particles collide and fall as precipitation. Okay, some precipitation falls as snow and can accumulate as ice caps and glaciers. Most precipitation falls back into oceans or onto land. On the land, the water flows over the ground as surface runoff. A portion of runoff enters rivers, which eventually joins seas and into the ground as infiltrations. Once again, the process of evaporation is triggered, and in this way the water cycle keeps continuing. Okay. Right. Now about ocean water. Right. What is ocean water? We know that about 70% of Earth's surface is covered with water, and from all the water, among all the water, 97.3% of total water on the earth is saline water, hai na, which is in the oceans, is filled with salt and many other dissolved minerals, which makes it unfit for human consumption. Although the salt can be removed, but it is very much difficult and expensive process. How many oceans are there? 5 distinct oceans are there: Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and Antarctic Ocean. Yet they are, here you can see, single. This is Southern Ocean, this is Indian Ocean. Names are given separate, but they are interconnected. Okay, they are connected to one another, right? And Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean among all the oceans, and it covers about 1/3 area of the Earth's surface. And Atlantic Ocean is the second largest ocean and also has the longest coastline. This is Atlantic Ocean and the longest coastline it has. See, and it makes the English letter S. You can see. Okay. Third one is Indian Ocean. It is the third major ocean, unlike the Atlantic and the Pacific Ocean, that extend into both hemispheres. Right? The ocean extend mostly in the southern hemisphere, means mostly in the southern hemisphere. Right? Bay of Bengal is there, and the Arabian Sea is there, are its two major extensions in the northern hemisphere. In between, equator is there. This is northern hemisphere and this is southern hemisphere. Mostly it lies in southern hemisphere and some part in northern hemisphere. And one side Bay of Bengal and another side Arabian Sea is there. Right? Due to its limited extension into northern hemisphere, Indian Ocean is often called half an ocean. And it is the only ocean which named after a country. Next, Arctic Ocean. Arctic Ocean. It is the smallest ocean in the world. Here, it is the Arctic Ocean. It is the smallest ocean in the world. It is the northernmost ocean. Means it is in northern hemisphere only. And the north pole of the earth is situated in this ocean only. Okay. And the last one is Antarctic Ocean. It is also known as Southern Ocean, as it extends wholly in the southern hemisphere. And it mostly wholly extend in the southern hemisphere. It surrounds the Antarctica. This is Antarctica. It surrounds the Antarctica. Okay. Now, salinity of what of the ocean? Salinity of ocean refers to the amount of salt present in unit volume of the ocean water. On an average, the salinity of ocean water is 3.5% or 35 gram per liter, which means every 1 liter roughly 1 kilogram by weight or of water has approximately 35 grams of dissolved salt in it. The salinity of sea water does not remain same everywhere. Here is a list. Anna, names are given of different seas and salinity level also given. Right. The salinity of sea water does not remain same everywhere. It varies depending on the temperature, depth, precipitation rate, evaporation rate, etc. Thus, it is clear that in reason of high rainfall like equatorial region and reason of low evaporation, with sufficient water source from melting ice like in polar regions, the salinity will be low, and the tropical region where the rate of evaporation is higher, the salinity will also be higher. Okay. Temperature of ocean water. How we can measure temperature of like land masses? Temperature of ocean water varies from one place to another. Okay. The surface of the ocean is heated by the sun. Thus, the temperature of water surface will be higher near the equator. This temperature gradually decreases as one moves towards poles. One moves towards pole, it will be decreases. The surface water temperature can be as high as 26 degrees near the equator and can be as low as -2 degrees near the poles. Also, the temperature of water varies with the depth also. Water will be much cooler at greater depth as compared to the surface water. It can be as high as 26 degrees Celsius on the surface near equator and -1 degree Celsius at the seabed. Okay. Now about ocean water in movements. What are the movements or circulation of water? First of before this, I want to tell you some importance. Why oceans are important? Oceans are reserves of high diversities like coral reefs, mangroves, marshes, estuaries are found there. Okay. It supports a lot of organisms also there, minerals also there found in oceans. Besides sustaining life, ocean also facilitate international transport. Means ships moves from one country to another. It gives a great way, waterways for the transportation. Oceans are also reserves of oil and natural gases. Valuable minerals like salt, bromine, magnesium, etc. are obtained from ocean water. Okay, in countries like Kuwait and Israel, etc., having hardly any source of fresh water, what they do with ocean water? The ocean water is desalinated to produce fresh water. Now about ocean water in movements. We know that the earth is in continuous motion through its rotation and revolution. When earth and these oceans are on the earth only, when earth will move, water will also be moved, na? So there are various endogenic and exogenic forces acting on it. All these factors, along with the variable density, temperature and salinity of the ocean water, cause continuous movement in the ocean water. This large scale movement of ocean water is known as circulation of or the movement in the ocean waters. Okay, the three major movements of ocean water that we will study here are waves, tides, and waves, tides, and ocean currents. Okay. What are waves? We must have seen waves, this kind of waves. Seen waves on the seashore or on TV, we may have seen. When winds blow over the surface of the ocean water, it causes ripples and oscillation of water particles. This result in forward movement of the ocean's water with alternate rise and fall of water on the ocean surface. This is known as wave. The waves are never of uniform size. Each wave moves with different speed and different height. The heights point of a wave is known as a crest and the lowest point is known as the trough. Okay. And the horizontal distance between two crests or troughs is size of the wave, i.e. length, wavelength. The vertical distance between the crest and the trough is called wave. Is called wave height. This is wave height. Okay, when waves travel, it appears that water is traveling. In fact, it is not. It is the wave's energy that is moving through water. Sometimes large endogenic movement in the ocean, earth crust, or other movement result in very huge waves known as tsunami. Okay, about tsunami we will study afterwards. Now about tide. Water tides, the sun and the moon exert gravitational pull on the earth's surface. The combined effect of this gravitational pull of the sun and the moon along with the rotation of the earth causes a periodic rise and fall of sea level at regular intervals twice a day. This rise and fall of sea level is known as a tide. The tide of the sea level is high tide, and when the sea level falls, it is low tide. Okay. When the earth and the sun and the moon in a straight line, the combined gravitational force of the sun and the moon is stronger and both contribute to the tides, resulting in strong tides like the highest and the lowest tides. These tides are known as spring tides. Spring tides will be course occur during the new moon and full moon phases. Okay. And when the moon and the sun are perpendicular to one another with respect to the earth, the gravitational force of the moon is counterbalanced by that of the sun. This results in weak tides known as neap tides. Neap tides occur during quarter moons, during the first quarter and the last quarter. Now, what are the significances and importance of tides? During a high tide, the volume of water at the mouth of river increases. This makes it easy for the ships to reach the ports, and thus it increases navigability in rivers. Another importance is tides help in cleaning the waste material from the mouth of a river, and tide also provide potential sources for generating hydroelectricity. And tidal energy is being used to generate electricity as in Canada also, United Kingdom, France. Now I will teach you about next ocean currents. What are ocean currents? Ocean currents are large masses of surface water that moves in a fixed path around the oceans. Thus, ocean currents, due to their movement within the ocean, are sometimes known as rivers in the oceans. The movement of ocean current can be vertical or horizontal. Ocean currents can be of two types, right? some currents, surface currents and deep currents. Surface currents are formed when wind blow over the water surface. They are created mainly by prevailing wind, example trade winds, westerly winds, etc. While deep currents are caused due to the variation in temperature, salinity, density, etc. of the ocean water. The equatorial water are warmer as compared to water at the polar region. Thus, the flow of warm water from equatorial region towards poles is known as warm current. The waters at the poles are cooler and as compared to water near the equator. Thus, the flow of cooler water from polar regions towards equatorial is known as cold currents. And what are the effects of ocean currents or significance of the ocean currents? The warm and the cold currents increase or decrease the temperature of the coastal areas and thus modify the coastal climate to the large extent. Ocean currents also affect trade and navigation, as sailing in the direction of currents is economical and time saving. The mixture of cold and warm currents creates foggy weather, an undesirable situation for navigation and shipping. Ocean currents transport plankton with them, which are useful food for fishes. This effect fishes and movement of fishing grounds. The reason of mixing of cold and warm ocean current has abundant of plankton and thus become the richest fishing grounds in the world. Okay, next is tsunami. This is flurry of ocean waters. What is this? Tsunami? A large mass of sea water may form a massive sea wave, can be devastate a coastal area, means very high tides. It is unusually triggered off by a displacement of rocks on the seafloor. Means it comes out from the sea and spoils everything. Many cities also, big cities also, it can spoil. Such large vertical movements and displacement of the crust generally occur at plate boundaries. Okay. What is the reason of tsunami? The main reason of tsunami is the earthquake in the seabed. Okay. So, when the sea floor displaces, then this kind of situation occurs. In the open sea, the height of wave may be only about 1 meter, but its speed can be from 500 to 1,000 kilometers per hour. Because of speed only, it creates so mass. Okay, and speed of tsunami reduces close to shore, but its height increases. When it comes on the shores, its height increases. Okay, after reaching the coast, a tsunami lashes onto the land, destroys structures, buildings, and all that comes in the way, destroys everything.
here is a case study of Japan tsunami. You will read it, write it, write important things. Means you will first you will write about in tsunami, what is tsunami, okay, in your notebook. Then what you will write, the reasons of tsunami, and then what happened when tsunami occurred in Japan, the all detail you will write yourself in the notebook, okay. You will read from here also, you will find from Google also, okay students. Now the chapter is over. Stay home, stay safe, bye.